Negro Leagues baseball was so popular that black churches would move their service time up an hour so fans could go to the game. If you know anything about the black church, you'll mess with service time.
There were African American professional ball players in the 19th century.
But segregation starts to tighten its hold.
Well, what do you do?
We can do this on our own.
A few entrepreneurs see that a black club can be a successful business.
Rube Foster,
light years ahead of his time.
Effa Manley,
the first lady of black baseball.
Negro Leagues players made the game more up-tempo, bunt and run.
Base stealing, these incredibly acrobatic catches.
The major leaguers would say that the Negro Leagues didn't play the game the right way. Really, that was saying they didn't play the game the white way.
It's you and me against the world.
Wherever you had successful black baseball, you typically had thriving black economies.
You have vendors and you have advertising. You know, people were making money from it.
But integration was going to kill their businesses.
It was good morally, but that progress came at a cost.
White fans saw a kind of baseball they had never seen before.
The great ball players of the leagues.
Jackie Robinson.
Buck Leonard.
Satchel Paige.
Willie Mays.
Cool Papa Bell.
Hank Aaron.
Oscar Charleston.
Joshua Gibson.
Would transform the game.
They are a part of a movement. Before we coined the term civil rights movement.
Man, they didn't care about making no history. They just wanted to play ball. But the pride, the passion, the courage in the face of adversity, that's the real story.